The new Galaxy A52 and the A72 software update has rolled out, and apparently this is one of the biggest updates for these two phones to date. I'll quickly take you through this update, and in the meanwhile, don't forget to subscribe and become a part of my journey to 100k. Okay, I've got the A72 here, but the update has brought the same improvements for both the A52 and the A72. So you can definitely consider this video valid for the A52 as well. First of all, this update brings a July security patch for some users, and some will still see the June security patch. I am personally still on the June security patch. My security patch updates are almost 1 month behind, but in terms of the features in the update, I have got the latest one. The very first edition is the remastered photos. Your phone can now automatically pick the photos, analyze and apply the necessary edits. You can view these photos in the remastered photos tab. To do so, you will click on the options key on the lower right corner of the screen in the phone's gallery. Go to the suggestions, and if there are any remastered photos, they will appear here. My phone hasn't detected a single photo to be remastered since yesterday, and hence I have no photos here, but you can check your phones and see if there are any remastered photos. This is a completely automatic feature. You cannot handpick photos on the A52 and the A72. However, on the flagships like the S21 Ultra, you can handpick the photos and remaster them on the go. This is how the remastered tab will look like on your A72. I am using my S21 Ultra for the demonstration. You can first view the resolution change. It shows you the original and the changed resolution. And then you can view the original and the remastered photo just like this. If you like the remastered photo, you can save it to your phone's gallery. Now, as soon as you capture a photo on your phone and you quickly view it in the gallery, you will see the photo changing its colors. This is because the phone automatically fixes the color tone, the brightness and the other elements, just as we can read in the update's change log. This is a very nice addition, as it can massively improve the overall look of your images. Next up is the camera stability. I am not sure what camera stability is this, but some viewers suggested that Samsung has improved the photo and video stability. So here are a few video clips. Okay guys, this is a 4K at 30 frames per second video. Now, I am recording this video after the July update, and the whole purpose of this video is to give you guys an idea about the stability. Do not focus on the other elements here, because I am recording this video on my rooftop and I don't have quite a view for the video, but I think this is still good enough to show you how Samsung has improved the stability. I think there is a little bit of improvement in the stability. The video is not as shaky as it appeared in my very recent updated camera review of this phone. Let me know about your thoughts about the video stability as well, because I don't want to be the only guy judging this video stability right here. Let me just show you an other resolution as well. Well, this is now 1080p at 60 frames per second video, and I am walking once again. Remember, these are the handheld videos, and with a gimbal you can add a whole lot of stability in these videos. I think there is definitely an improvement in the stability. Although Samsung just mentioned that they improved the camera stability, they did not mention that they improved the video stability. I don't know what they mean by camera stability. I believe that the camera stability is basically the stability for the videos and the images. In this mode, the EIS worked before, so I think there is an improvement in the software now. Alright, this is now 1080p at 30 frames per second video with optical image stabilization. And once again, you guys have to be the judge for the video stability. The OS is working, but I can see a little bit of shake here. Since you guys have already seen all of my previous A72 videos, I think you guys can definitely draw a comparison right here. I think this is improved, but there is still a lot of room for improvement here. this is not the best optical image stabilization. I think this is not what we are supposed to get. Samsung should still consider further improvements in the stability of this phone's camera. Samsung also says that they have improved the overall picture quality, and some users under my community post suggested that they are seeing massive changes in the telephoto lens's quality. So I went ahead and captured some new images to also check what color tone differences are there. These are all very good images and I am not sure if there are any improvements. These images look good, overall details are good, saturation is on point, the phone does quickly analyze and fix the images right after you capture them. As I just told you before, you will note the pictures improving a bit in real time. I also took a couple of telephoto images, my own images I mean. These are 3x images. If your subject is placed too close to the camera, the 3x camera can also add depth to the image, just like this one, but it's not as good as the portrait image. Here is a comparison between the several focal lengths that I took the images at. Let's take a look at some new and old images. The old images were taken under different lighting conditions and different time of the day. So there's that difference. But you guys need to keep your eyes on the details and overall picture quality. To be honest, to me, the old images at some instances look more sharp, but the new images are not that bad either. The light wasn't that bright today and the sky wasn't that blue either. So judge these images and let me know if you think the new ones are better or the old ones are still better. All I know is that 3x telephoto resolution has definitely improved and the 3x images are almost as good as the images taken on the main camera of the phone. So there's that. In the end, Samsung has improved the call quality and the face recognition. The phone unlocks fine with the face ID recognition, no problems there at all. The overall security of the phone has improved as it does with every new security update. In terms of performance, I didn't see a huge difference. The phone was snappy before and it is snappy even now. The fingerprint scanner also works up to the mark. The benchmark scores were also the same as before. And that's all with this latest update. Drop your feedback in the comments below. Subscribe if you haven't yet. With that being said, I will sign off and see you all in the next one.